In local corporate news, PXP Energy narrows its core net loss in the first 9 months of the year. It stood at 17.8 million pesos from last year's nearly 24 million. That's thanks to a slight pickup in the average price of crude oil and output from its Galok field operations. Petroleum revenues were also a bit higher at 65 million pesos. The joint venture backed by the MVP Group says it's studying more oil and gas projects in the Philippines. Fuel retailer Topline Business Development Corporation gets the Philippine Stock Exchange's green light to proceed with an initial public offering. Cebu-based Topline has its IPO listing tentatively slated from November 27 to December 3. Topline plans to offer up to 3.68 billion primary shares, potentially priced at 78 centavos apiece. The company is aiming to raise 3.16 billion pesos at its maximum offer price. Topline Group's president and CEO Eric Lim told ANC in July its focus has been to expand its footprint in the fuel retail market. Topline operates its retail distribution network of light fuels chains primarily in Central Visayas. Banks are approaching a sweet spot. That's according to Standard Chartered CEO Bill Winters. He says lenders are in a good position to maintain current strong performance levels even as interest rates come down. The U.S. Federal Reserve began its long-awaited easing cycle last month after a years-long monetary policy tightening to fight inflation.
So rates, we all expect rates to come down. Really active debate whether they're going to come down faster or slower, but you know, obviously we'll see how that plays out. All else equal, lower rates will impact our earnings, and we've been very transparent about that, as it will most other banks. But it will also provide a bit of a stimulus to the economy and should allow us to keep our credit costs very low.
Elon Musk in hot water following his $1 million a day election giveaway. The tech tycoon was ordered to appear in court Thursday in a lawsuit filed by the Philadelphia District Attorney's Office. The DA described as illegal lottery the giveaway by Musk's campaign group, which backs former President Donald Trump. Musk promised to give away $1 million each day to voters in battleground states who sign up in the online petition by his Political Action Committee. AstraZeneca's China president, under investigation by Chinese authorities, the pharmaceutical giant in a statement said Leon Wang is cooperating in the probe but did not provide further details. In September, China detained a small number of AstraZeneca's current and former employees for questioning. At the time, Bloomberg News reported that five people were detained for questioning about potential illegal activities and that one of the investigations was related to the firm's collection of patient data. On Thursday, China's foreign ministry said Beijing welcomes foreign enterprises to invest and do business in the country and that it will protect their legitimate rights and interests in accordance with the law, close quote. The Philippine Energy Department says the private sector is on board with its plans to establish a nuclear energy source in the country by 2032. According to Patrick Aquino of the DOE's Energy Utilization Bureau, companies are eyeing small modular reactors due to their manageable entry barrier and manageable capacities of 150 to 300 megawatts.
Right now, you're aware that in the regulatory framework that we have with the EPIRA in place, power generation really is driven, investments in power generation is driven by the private sector. That's why there's a pending measure in the Senate right now on the nuclear regulatory authority. But you know, our private sector partners were working, they've joined us for study and scientific visits. They're working on the assumption that you know, they would be investing. They will be partnering. They'll be forming a consortium to bring in this technology.